Yeah, of course you can.
Get a girlfriend. I do have a girlfriend.
You gonna see it all this summer?
Yeah.
She's coming today.
Yeah.
What's she gonna say?
Porque no me va a dar el.
You got guests from the town.
Me dice luego cuando venga Robin, porque está viendo. No, no, todavía el stream está corriendo, ¿verdad? El stream todavía está corriendo. Todo está funcionando.
Nada, bueno, padre,
tío. Es como si
Oh my God, what is going on here?
I don't know how long we have.
A minute. All right, I didn't want to mess with nothing. You know, you know how you are about your stuff.
Importante que yo tengo acceso, ¿ok? Me llamas cualquier cosa.
Está bien.
I just let that go a little longer, you know why? Because I just love that song. So Harry got me set up in the Star Trek Enterprise. So now I got to work all the computers today. I'm going to learn. So, and then he's got his phone behind me flashing. Scared the mess out of me. I was like, what is that? DEF CON 3? What's happening? So if you come to our studio, it is a full-fledged studio set up with all the gadgetry that you see on TV. What are you doing, Harry? I hear you over there.
Oh, sorry. Oh, good morning.
Good morning. So if you just tuned in, you know it's time for Love Baths, Love Talk on 103.5 FM WNHH. Live streaming on the New Haven Independent. And we are Facebook Live and YouTube Live. So if you just want to see an egg on wheels, I'm it. So I have the roundest head of anybody. I'm going to get my color. I'm going over to CK today and get my hair colored back totally platinum because I miss it.
Should I like go platinum and
in your beard?
My beard?
You're almost there, homie. You're almost there.
This way we're matching.
Yes, because it's important to match on radio. So do you know June is Black Music Month? June is Black Music Month. Well, we play a lot of black music up here anyway, because I'm black, we black, black. But June is Black Music Month, and so, you know, I'm going to try to play a little bit of everything. Because it's Black Music Month, and there'll be no trap music.
What?
Where's that Sam? Oh, I sent him to fetch me some coffee. I love an intern. Fetch me some coffee, intern.
Yeah, he was really an intern yesterday with Alyssa.
Did she like make him salsa down the stairs?
Well, actually, they found out that she actually taught him salsa when he was like 7.
Oh my God. Yeah. And he speaks Spanish, doesn't he?
He understands it.
Oh, he understands. Oh, when he's mocking his mama.
Yeah, that's the only time he speaks it.
So anyway, today is January 2nd. January 2nd. You can see, look where I'm at. It's June 2nd, although the weather will make you feel like it's January. But today is gorgeous, although possibility of rain this afternoon.
Yeah, but it's going to get around 76. That's not bad.
No, I got on sandals. I got on so much black, I feel like Johnny Cash.
And I don't have...
I walked the line.
I'm not completely black today.
I know. What? Harry got on some khaki shorts. Are those shorts?
Yep.
Harry got on khaki shorts. I didn't even think you owned anything other than black.
Yeah.
And gray. And gray, black. Black,
but,
gray.
But it was like 46 this morning.
It was.
So...
It was. I slept good last night.
It was good. The cool air coming in.
Yeah. So. So let me get started with some music. Okay. So Harry, when I'm over here, I can just click on what I want.
Yep. You can scroll.
I'm gonna play some Chaka Khan.
Chaka Khan.
Cause I feel for you. All right, so the new edition of The Inner City is out. So I want you.
That one right there.
The new edition, that's Mrs. Mills. She passed away. She was a longtime writer for The Inner City. So her service is today. And taking up the other quarter of the page is my big giant head from the community conversation. I mean, the community, to the talk that I had. For education excellence, you know, Mercy Quay and the crew. So I ran the piece that Tom Breen wrote, and I ran the piece. I ran both pieces that Sam the intern wrote. So I have to show him so he'll see, so he could be pleasantly surprised. So it's like, look, boy, you're in here.
I don't read the Independent.
You don't? Why?
I don't know. I just.
You don't have time.
I bypass it all the time.
When do you have time?
My wife tells me, do you read? I'm like, yeah, no.
No, I read it. I don't do the comments as much as I used to. Like, when they first started, I was always on the comments. But now, these people are so insufferable, I just can't. You know, my patience for stupidity is just low.
See, my problem, like, I have thought about commenting, but since I'm an administrator, it always ends up coming up as WNHH.
Oh.
And not Harry.
Oh, okay.
And I can't comment.
Yeah.
Under WNHH.
So just get out and go under your own thing.
No, but that's what I'm saying. It's like, it's weird the way my Facebook account is now.
Oh.
Every time I comment on anything WNHH, I'm an administrator, so it comes up WNHH.
Thank you.
The only thing is that you have to be aware of that mouse all the time.
I know. You see me, right?
So it doesn't go into sleep mode.
Chaka Khan on 103.5 FM on WNHH. You are tuned in to Love Babs Love Talk. And me and Harry are hanging out today. And it is Black Music Month. June is Black Music Month.
And it's Party Friday.
And it's Party Friday, baby. So we're going to keep it black up in here. And we're going to party down and party hard. I was trying to figure out what I have to do this weekend. I was hanging out with Markeisha last night. We was over at Woodbridge Social. You know what? We need to, every place we go, Woodbridge Social. Nice little restaurant.
Cheap, they said something eats. In Spanish.
Cheap. Cheap eats, good beer. So we were there for a little bite to eat last night. Caught some of the games. It's like a sports bar, too. So we hung out there, ate a little bit something. So we're just trying to figure out what we're going to do this weekend. Because I know she's covering the food truck festival, which is Saturday. Which will be a nice day for the food truck. I've not gone in the 3 years they've done it. So I don't know if I'll get over there. And then... Kay has got the Caribbean Festival Sunday, so I'm looking forward to that. I go to that every year because I like to get my vibe on. So get my vibe on. And then, you know, Ms. Mills' funeral, Marjorie Mills' services today at 5:30 over at Bethel. Ms. Mills was a longtime writer, contributor to the Inner City News, and she passed away a couple of weeks ago. She was like 83 or something. Anyway, she's on the cover of the Inner City. So if you see me on Facebook Live, here is the latest edition of the God bless you, Harry, the Inner City News. And so pick it up. It's hitting the streets now. So check that out. And so I'm going to go over there to that because we ran her obituary in the paper and some pictures. Her daughter sent some pictures of her and her family. So we ran those. She was such a strong contributor to the paper. When I came back, and she had such a huge reputation and a huge following, that up until recently, people were still calling to see if I could send her to cover. I said, well, first of all, I don't send Ms. Mills anywhere. Ms. Mills tells me what she's going to cover. And third of all, Ms. Mills politely told me 2 years ago she was retired. So, one, I can't tell her what to do, and two, she's retired. And she meant it, too. She was like, I ain't covering nothing. If I go to something, it's because I have the pleasure to do it. I'm not covering anything. So I was like, okay. And, you know, Ms. Mills was, she had to be like, I don't know, maybe 4'11", maybe.
Oh, that tiny?
Oh, she's tiny.
Oh, wow.
And she was alive. She probably was like, Babs, I'm 5'1", but no, she wasn't. And she was a wisp of a woman. I mean, just... But she was smart, and she wrote well, and she was, you know, she just was an interesting woman. and she'll be greatly missed by this community. Greatly missed. So I'm going to go over to her service today, and I know I'm going to need a beer after. I know I'm going to need some kind of thing, but I'm going to go over to Kay's and get my hair colored at 1:30 today, because I got to get my color back, because I don't like this salt pepper. You know why? Because everywhere I go, people think I'm Markeisha's mother. I don't appreciate that. I didn't really do it because it's the hair color, because they see all the gray hair, and they just assume, you know, I'm an old lady.
I actually like it.
I like it, too, but I like it white all the way.
Okay.
And if I lost the weight, I wouldn't look so old either. I think weight puts age on you. That's just my take on it. So, anyway. Don't get me started. Don't even get me started. So, that's where we are for today. It's a beautiful day. Thank God.
Beautiful day out there. And it's only going to be a passing shower, they said. A possible passing shower.
I got my sandals on. I don't care because I wanted. I don't care. I got to put some sandals on. I cannot wear another shoe.
The only thing about it is that I feel all the pollen.
Oh, I know, because I see you sniffing over there.
Oh my God!
Let me shout out Joe Ugly and my Ugly Radio family. Thank you, because they always lead in the morning with, you know, shouting me out.
Well, they give you love, and they throw shade on me. I don't know what's up with that.
Oh. Joe Ugly, cut my producer some slack. So we're just going to have to roll over there and just bum rush them. Just take over their studio. Let's do it, Harry, one day. Just plan. And we just roll up in there and just take over their daggone studio one morning. And just like duct tape Joe to the wall. Just take over.
Be like, you got jokes.
We got jokes too. So. All right, let me play some more music in celebration of June is Black Music Month.
I think Sam went to make you coffee at his house.
Yeah, I think so. He went up to the hills of Jamaica to get the coffee and ground it.
You're listening to Love Babs Love Talk on WNHHLP 103.5 FM.
Because we are family up in here, Sister Sledge and Chic. Ooh. I don't know if this is recording. Is it supposed to be blue?
No.
It's supposed to be recording. Okay, now it is. It stopped for some reason.
It does that sometimes.
Okay.
But it's
recording.
It's registering it?
Well, I don't know what it's doing.
It's sometimes
it's not doing anything.
No.
It's just recording.
You know what I think it is that he sits down to eat his breakfast.
Okay.
And then he comes.
Well, that can't go like that. And I want my coffee.
Oh, what are we doing the next hour? You got a guess?
I don't have a guess. I don't know anything. I don't know. What do you want to do? Do you want to play around with more music, or do you want to put in a show?
Up to you.
Matter.
We could talk about anything. Poor Lucy out here.
Who?
Lucy.
Yeah.
Lucy, you want to be a guest at 10? Babs doesn't have a guest. Schmoozing, making connections.
Sam? Yeah, bring my damn coffee.
Hola.
Now you gonna take it? Wait, let me put my headphones on right. Do you know how to take the picture where I move a little bit? Do you know how to do that?
Yeah, the action picture.
Yeah.
Let's see. I think my phone's up.
Are you taking an action picture?
Oh, you want me to? Hold on. Sorry,
that's. Ow! Hey! Song. I like it though. It's long. We got like 3 more minutes.
Real? Oh, that's a mix. That's
Oh, is that what that is?
The club mix.
Oh.
So it goes on forever.
All right. Well, get your club on, people. We're going to give it to you. Do we have a clean version of Bruno Mars?
Which one?
You know.
24 karat.
I like what I like.
Yeah, I have a couple of versions there.
All right, I don't want to.
Well, click on his thing. That's what it should say. Radio edit or.
All right. Well, I'm not gonna play it next. Cause I'm gonna play. I'm playing Aretha Franklin next.
That's what I'm going to do with Sam. I'm going to sit him down, make him go through all of our music and
clean it up
or mark it so we know what everything is. It might torture him because he only likes trap music.
I know, right? Listen, boy.
Tomorrow I'm going bike riding early.
Oh shit.
And then to see Wonder Woman.
Oh yeah. Oh, you got tickets?
Yeah, I'm going tomorrow.
How do you get the tickets?
You have to go like in the middle of the day when nobody's there, you know. You can't go in the evening. It's awful.
I don't want to go in the evening. I don't want to go with everybody. personally. I like going by my dad going. Yeah. I like having the theater to myself. Why, you need like a whole theater of people?
No, I don't. But, you know, it's hard to.
All right. That was a club mix.
Yeah.
It's like 20 minutes.
We are family.
That's a club mix. Because we want to make sure you got your dance on wherever you are. Yeah. So if my sister Lo is working out down there in Jersey,
you got
some music for you right there.
It kept people bouncing.
Kept you bouncing. Get all y'all with them Fitbits. That gave you some steps right there. Because on 103.5 FM, baby, WNHH, we give it to you. We give it to you. It's Black Music Month, June. And, look, we got festivals coming up. Motown the Musical is here. Week after next, we got flood the week with Motown music. That's what we should do.
Yeah, I know we have a lot of concerts because we had the Cool Breeze or the Summer Breeze concerts yesterday. Yeah. But they were talking about being all over the place. Everywhere.
Yeah, so I'm gonna try to. I'm gonna see. Last year I had a challenge. How much stuff can I make at the Arts and Ideas Festival?
That is the hard one.
Woo, Harry. I did it, though. I went to a lot of stuff. I'm going to see how much I can get to this year.
I got to take a look at the artists, and I'll probably show up like twice.
I'm going to try to go to as much stuff as I can. All the free stuff.
Yeah, but you see, you like being right there in the mix.
I do. So, you know what? I'm going to go to all the free stuff that I can go to.
Oh, I just renamed the show. What? In the mix.
In the mix.
In the mix with Babs.
In the mix in the morning. Oh, I like that, Harry. We need to change it. In the mix in the morning with Babs. I like that. In the mix. We in the mix, baby. So, yeah. I'm going to try to go to everything. I got an email yesterday from Frank Mitchell, who's the executive director of the Amistad Cultural Center in Hartford. And they're having their Juneteenth gala, Juneteenth. You know what Juneteenth is? It's that time when the slaves were emancipated.
Yeah.
The news took so long to try. It took about a year, almost 2 years to get across the country. And so it's celebrated as Juneteenth because we don't exactly know. The news traveled in such a way that it took a bit for it to reach some slaves, enslaved people. And I think it was because, you know, some of these plantation owners just
didn't want to hear it.
Didn't want to share that information. It wasn't like there was some, you know, everybody was on like Facebook.
Exactly.
you had to, somebody had to ride your horse across the country with the message or the telegraph or whatever it was. And I don't even think there was telegraph. No, telegraph came much later.
I was looking at History Channel yesterday.
You had to go wait for somebody on a horse to bring a message.
And they were saying how it's incredible how we've gone from horse and buggy.
Yeah.
Well, even if you just go up to the 1960s, 1969 when we went to the moon, from horse and buggy to the moon in 60 years.
Yeah. Can you imagine?
It's insane. And now look where we are. It's like,
I know.
Ridiculous.
It is. It really is. I'm in awe of science and technology and the stuff that we are able
to do. What would people call? I'm on the radio. The second call.
It might be an emergency. Did they leave a message?
No.
Oh, no.
But it is. It's crazy how far we've come.
Yeah, it's amazing. That's why when I see these science deniers, I'm always like, how sad for you.
Well, yeah,
like all these beautiful things that science has done, the lives saved, and just the things that we know now that we didn't know.
Well, yeah, and the only thing that I look back and actually, I mean, I'm young compared to most of the people who experienced the NASA program, but they had a goal of colonization. And then they just stopped in the 70s of going to the moon.
Yeah.
And I would like to know why.
Well, I think, as I recall, I mean, there's a lot of people who felt like going out of space was, one, an abomination to God.
Oh, yeah.
So you have those people. And two, why would we delve into science? Why would we delve into outer space when we have so much we need to do? And we really just wanted to beat the Russians to the moon. Yeah. That really was the goal.
Yeah, it was the race to space.
You know, it was the race to space, and we won it. But well, we didn't win it.
But think about it. They said that about heart surgery, right? You got people in the 20s or something cursing heart surgery. The people trying to heal heart.
But anything, right? But listen, when Florence Nightingale showed up and said, you know, we really ought to wash our hands and wash these utensils. we really shouldn't be cutting people without washing our hands. And before that, they would just operate on you, come out from the field and just cut you up. And then you wouldn't die from that. You'd die from
the infection. It's crazy.
And, you know, they fought her. They were like, you're a woman. You don't know what you're talking about. She's like, a little soap and water here.
You see how they got rid of the plagues, right? They started using bleach. Cleaning stuff.
Right, you have to clean stuff. But can you imagine the arguments that people were having around just basic...
I wonder why this is spreading. You should wash your face.
Wash your hands. Yeah. Like, you're out there working in the field, and then you're coming in the house. You have to wash up.
And now we're hyper clean, right? Because we have that.
Now we have antibacterial stuff. Soap, condoms,
everything.
To the point now where they're saying, stop using that stuff. I thought you was making the coffee.
To us?
All right, we play another song in celebration of Black Music Month because that's what we do here. So I really like this version. Speaking of the Beatles. But this is Aretha Franklin's take on Eleanor Rigby, which is one of the coolest remakes ever. So what mic are you on? What is that?
4. And we're not on right now. When you're on your mic, kick it all the way up. So that's 1 all the way up because you're moving your head to look at the music.
Oh, you can't hear me.
Yeah, you come in and out.
Okay. Do I have change?
$8 of change. They're going $2.
All right. I was like, I ain't giving you an $8 tip.
Well, think about it. He went all the way to...
Went all the way to Istanbul. Yeah. Did you eat breakfast?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. That's what we said. He's like... That me eat your breakfast. Thank you, my dear.
So I was telling Babs that you got some salsa moves.
God, no. No. I'm about as limber as a piece of wood. Like, no, I'm not. I can't move. My knees are out.
But you said glasses.
How are you? You are half Latino. What is wrong with you?
I'm half Jewish, too. That's the rhythmic part I got. All I got is the head bob. That's it.
That's a shame.
Or the shoulders. I'll throw the shoulders.
You can't be Latino and don't have no rhythm.
That's why his mother put him in school.
Yeah, that's why she put me in salsa lessons.
She's like, dance, boy, dance.
You're not going to embarrass me when we go to people's quinceañeras. You're not going to embarrass me when we go to family stuff.
She loves me dancing with her at family stuff. She'll be like, somebody, $5 if you dance with me right now. Mira, come on. Me and your grandma, let's go. I've never seen any of the money.
Boy, ain't you in school?
Yeah, I'm not complaining. I still dance.
So you dance. You know how to dance. Because at least she...
No, I can keep my grandmother afloat while she's dancing to make sure she doesn't fall. I'm really just there to balance her.
Sam's over there. I'm just telling the people we're talking to Sam over there.
Yeah, cool.
They can't see you.
Let me tell you something. That is probably one of the coolest remakes of a song ever. Like Aretha, that's how you make a song your song, right? Like you don't even.
Wait, so are you saying that Eleanor Rigby is now Aretha Franklin's song?
It isn't. It's a Beatles song.
I'm saying you just said that's how you make it your song.
That's how you make it your song.
So Aretha, if you're gonna cover somebody's song,
you make it your song.
Yeah, but okay, I misunderstood. I thought you were saying that she like took the song.
Yeah, she did. She took it and made it her own song.
All right, that's good. That's good.
Yeah, that's. I thought you know. Listen, that's boss.
Yeah.
Right.
Aretha Franklin was pretty cool.
I can hear you.
Yeah, she's kind of cool, right?
I see why I can't hear you.
Four.
All right, I got you now. Yeah, Aretha Franklin is, and she's on her last tour. She's touring. This is it. She's done.
Okay. I don't think anyone's final tour has ever actually been
a final tour.
Who does that?
Nobody. Because you got it. I mean, Barbra Streisand has always said she stopped touring, and then but you know, she does tour for charity. Like she'll come out of retirement just to raise some money for somebody, and it's a whole bunch of money.
Yeah, people really like Barbra.
Oh, I would, if I could see her before I die, that would be she would be my ultimate person I want to see. Yeah. Oh.
You and my dad.
What? I love her. Let me tell you, I grew up watching Funny Girl, Funny Lady, and What's Up Doc, and On a Clear Day.
I tried to watch those movies, but I can't get.
Like don't piss me off.
That's 15 minutes.
Don't.
How about you, Sam? He doesn't even know what Funny Girl is.
I know who Barbra Streisand is.
Okay. Well, his father is Jewish.
Your father, right?
Yeah, I was about to say.
She's the leader of the Jews. So,
So he sat you down and you watched Funny Girl?
No, it's more from my other friend's Jewish parents. They have like a whole vinyl collection of Barbra Streisand. I know her music more than
you can't be Jewish and not have her music. I've got her music. I ain't nowhere near Jewish.
Shout out Eileen Bronin. That's my friend's mom. She has so much Barbra Streisand on her vinyl. So much.
Beth is not going to like this, but only movie I like it is Nuts.
You got to see Nuts. And I don't appreciate it.
With Barbra Streisand.
Who else is in there?
Richard Dreyfuss.
You're not like my Richard Dreyfuss. He's okay.
I'm thinking about forget him. Her, she was awesome in the movie. Right, Bev?
Yeah, she's awesome, but not as awesome as she was in.
You're not a mic,
Bev. The funny, not as awesome as the funny, as funny lady funny girl, and she sang those great songs. You know, whatever my man is. I am his. I'm not messing with y'all. You know who else is bad? La Boss. La Boss. La Boss. Y'all know who La Boss is?
No.
Okay, well, listen. I'm going to give you a little lesson.
You mean the boss or La Boss?
Diana.
Okay.
Oh,
I thought La Boss. The real boss.
The boss. And I'm not talking Bruce Springsteen.
Not Bruce Springsteen. The real
I'm talking boss. The boss.
Not grunting Bruce.
Born in the USA.
Only song I like.
I don't like Bruce Springsteen either.
What? I do like the boss.
I know this song. All right. That little guitar.
But you know what? Somebody should redo Barbra Streisand and trap music.
Hey. I only know this song because of a sample in a rap song.
Yeah,
it's in a Kendrick Lamar song. That little like guitar. But
you know what I'm saying? You think somebody?
It's in the best one is Diddy and Mace.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's
the biggest sample of this song.
Yeah,
that's what I was talking about.
Do we have that? I want to play that. Do we have it?
I know I got it.
Maybe.
We have to find all the clean stuff. See, that rap stuff is suspect.
Mace? Pastor Mace is suspect?
No. Before he was Pastor Mace, he was Diddy's boy, and they made some music.
Who's not?
It's not good. I don't like Diddy, but I think Diddy's a snake, but I like...
I like Diddy.
I like Biggie Alive. That was cool, I guess. That would have been nice. But Mace, he's a pastor now. He like does like...
Yeah, but he came back out of that for a minute. Well, I don't think he ever come out of it, but...
Well, he came out of it.
He came out of it.
He went with 50 for a while.
Yeah, he sold like a one album. I don't think it did that well. Like probably 15K the first week. Poor Mace. After he got knocked out by Ghostface Killah, it kind of all went downhill for him.
After he converted, it went downhill for him.
He broke his, like, Ghostface Killah broke his jaw. Ugh. That's crazy. That's crazy.
I think this was like the gay anthem. They love this. We go to the gay dance club. Oh,
this?
Yes.
Oh, I thought it was YMCA.
Yeah, that too.
I did not realize what that song was about, and then I read about it, and I was like, oh, that makes sense. Why the whole coordinated dance to it. Like,
yeah.
They got everybody dancing to it, too. There's no playlist in there. You know, there's playlists, but that's not the grouping of the list.
Yeah, we need to get that because this is a little I love it.
How did you transfer it over? Did you do that?
I grabbed the. I had all my music on a hard drive, so I just moved it over to here. Uh-huh. But the playlist don't transfer.
How many gigabytes do you have on there?
About a little over 300.
Is that all your music? How do you have 300 gigabytes of music?
A lot of my music got lost. My hard drive crashed. I didn't have a backup. I mean, all my old stuff got.
I thought I had a lot, and I have like 90 on my, and I need to do 100 on my iPhone.
I know that's nothing. I know I have it on old hard drives somewhere.
What?
All my music. This is it. Nothing. I had tons.
Yeah, I have like 10,000 songs right now. That's like what I'm saying.
Yeah, but all your music is.
You know, I ran a couple of your pieces in the inner city.
What?
I ran a couple of your pieces from the independent in the inner city.
Can I see it?
What? Find yourself. I think the Cardi B one, I had to change it. Well, y'all changed the title, which was good.
Yeah, that was not my title. I want.
And then the one on the Imam, I ran that. I'm like, oh, look at Sam. We're coming back in.
Imam starts next week.
Woohoo! Oh, what? So he's got a show?
Yeah.
Oh!
He's gonna be on there twice.
The Imam is gonna have a show?
Yep.
What's he gonna talk about? Muslim stuff? Or he's just gonna be talking about stuff?
Let me talk about stuff.
Because he's an Imam, not so much Muslim stuff.
I forgot what the name of the show is, but it's more of a positive, you know, a positive
show. Well, I would imagine he ain't gonna come out here talking about I'm a recruit for terrorism.
Well, not that, but I'm saying not just. Muslim positive.
World positivity. I'm with that. What the world needs now. If y'all just tuned in to 103.5 FM WNHH, we are live streaming on New Haven Independent. I am Love Babs Love Talk, and this is my hour of music. And June is Black Music Month, so we've been playing it pretty good.
Also, the month of my birthday.
When's your birthday?
In 3 days.
How old are you going to be, 20?
Yeah.
You know, you're the same age as my daughter.
That's pretty cool.
You could be my son.
You got a pair of sneakers his age.
I have a lot of things his age. Oh, Lord have mercy. I got date books his age. 20? What you going to do? Oh, that's what your girlfriend is coming.
I'm probably just...
You should sleep on the couch and she should sleep in your room.
Oh my god, you should talk to my mother. Yeah, you're right. You're probably right. Like, I don't know what I'm going to do. It's a Monday, so it's not like I can, like, do that many social activities. Last year, I got to see Kanye on my birthday. That was cool.
Who took you to that?
Myself. Oh. That was interesting. But
so what are you going to do this year?
I don't know. I kind of want to go to New York. I want to eat at the Seinfeld Diner. That'd be cool.
No, Tom's.
Yeah.
I've been there. I eat to Tom's.
It's pretty good. It's honestly not that bad.
No, I've been to Tom's. I used to work in New York. I was at a Tom's before it was Tom's. Like, okay. All these diners look the same to me. I love a diner, though, so don't get me wrong.
But it's good. It's New York. Diner.
Well, you go to New York. Hang out for the day. Go see some stuff. The museums are good. MoMA.
MoMA's cool.
Yeah. All that good stuff. Yeah, go.
I love
go. You know, get off at 125th Street and hang out in Harlem.
Ooh. That'd be cool.
You know, you go to Studio Museum in Harlem. Oh, they got such good eats now.
Harlem is different. I mean, not that you would know, but
Harlem is very Harlem's like Georgetown.
Harlem is way different.
I know, Harlem is like Georgetown. I know history.
It's like Brooklyn.
Yeah, you gotta go to Brooklyn.
I go to Brooklyn all the time. You know,
the white folks is trying to change Harlem to Soho.
Brooklyn, oh my God, it is the home of
like Georgetown.
People who really like Starbucks or like places that are just like Starbucks, but they don't want to call it Starbucks because they want to stay in Brooklyn.
Yeah, that's what it's becoming.
Yeah, I'm telling you, it's Georgetown. You've been to Georgetown. You were like, where am I? It's like, you feel like you're on a movie set. It's like, is this real?
Brooklyn is so nice, though. It's so
cool. It's nice now for folks. But... All right, let me just keep this music going because, let's see. I think now, Harry, I want a little bit of, let me go some real old school. I think I saw some Marvin Gaye. So this is some old Marvin Gaye. How sweet it is to be loved by you. So Motown the musical, we're gonna play Motown music all week. At least one or two songs every day. Just to stay in the spirit of Motown.
Motown the musical.
And they're not paying me to do this, but I just love the music so much that I tell you, I did work for the Motown Cafe when it was there. Bless you.
Salute.
And so it's good. I saw this in Hartford. It was good. God bless you. You have allergies too?
Kinda. I just sneeze a lot.
How many times have you seen Motown maps?
This would be my second time. I don't really like seeing stuff like that over and over. If I see it once, it stays with me. So, I don't read books over and over. Now people like to read. God bless you, child.
Not good.
Oh, that's right. I'm the next person.
We still got to. I think you got to wrap it up.
Next. Yeah, we do have to wrap it up. All right.
But you got to wrap it up even if she's the next person?
Yeah, because it's two different shows.
Yeah.
So she doesn't have, well, Lucy will probably be the guest. We'll all probably be the
guest. Everybody, you all will be the guest. We'll just chat.
So yeah, it's two different shows. Because I take Friday shows and I play them during the weekend. And so, where these are just during the week.
Oh, I got to go find Lovely Day, don't I?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Let's look for love, Babs.
Lord Harry.
Just look for love, Babs.
Babs intro? No.
There's a playlist called Love, Babs.
There it is. Dance all night. Oh, this song's about to go out. Because you know these Motown songs. They only like 2 minutes.
Oh, the spinners.
I don't know how I feel about the spinners. I like, they distract me. I thought they didn't, and then when I used them yesterday, and they distracted me.
I left my spinner in the car.
All right, I have to bounce out of here, but I'll be back in a few minutes. And then, you know, we'll be in here with the posse and we're just going to chat it up. So everybody's my guest today. at the next hour. So it's a lovely day. I'm gonna play us out, and there we go. And then I'll see y'all back on the other side.
Am I allowed to play? Can I play with these? Can I play with these?
Yeah.
All right. What do we need to do, Harry?
I know you need to be distracted. You mean?
Who, me?
Oh. This guy.
Yeah, because I got
the spinner works for you. You just won't admit it.
Oh, there's a piece. I pulled a piece. I put a piece in the paper about the spinners, Harry, because I was thinking about you. I said, you know what? Let me put this in here because Harry was talking about
this. No, the spinners don't work.
It does.
No, it makes me distracted.
No, it keeps you focused on the spinner.
I'm not missing the job. Oh! You need me to move? I forgot to put my app on.
Oh no.
It's actually working. Oh, please let it load. Yes. I hope I didn't get a ticket in those 10 minutes that I.
See where it says start playlist?
Where?
On the left side, towards the bottom. There's a big button in the middle, yeah. Hit start playlist. Hit it again. Now go back to iTunes and stop looking at me.
Show your mama.
Yeah,
oh, look, Dad, look.
I'm doing something with my time. When I told her I wasn't getting paid, she was like, what is this baloney job you're working? Mira, you need to get the money. I'm not paying for you no more. It wouldn't be right if I said the things that she said to me without putting the accent on. That adds the intensity to it.
Do you speak Spanish?
Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Slightly, right?
I can understand everything.
You can understand. For like,
All I know is I got...
You hear them. You
yeah.
You can speak it. You see how fast they talk it?
No, I can't. I have a full-on argument, like...
What book is that?
It is Me and Dad's For a Better America, The Generous Rewards of an Old-Fashioned Childhood.
What does that mean? Like, I beat my kids?
Yeah, that's what I think.
That's what it looks like.
You're going to get the bell.
Oh, it's by a Fox News host.
Oh, see. Oh. Sid, that's the bullshit right Sid, there.
Sid most certainly did not represent.
What you're gonna do now?
Uh-oh, you pay attention.
Is you're gonna go to the back intro that you saw over?
Yeah.
And try it with your arm.
Go on now. Okay.
You see the top one right on?
Is that the one?
That's yours for this show.
Okay. Started?
No, not yet.
Oh,
not yet. Because you gotta stop. Now you're gonna have to stop the playlist, and then you're gonna start that, but only when you're ready to start your show.
Oh, I've got like 2 minutes.
Yeah. So wait for the. Click on the black screen over there.
And
yeah, just click on it. Yeah. Now go to open. You see it?
Yeah.
And go to jingle and IDs, the one on the top. Double click. Okay. Good. And there you go. The station ID this time.
Okay.
So. Play your music and then you can hit record.
Hi, this is
Sophie.
Okay.
All right, what is this?
Yeah. Are you sending it?
Do I need to do something with this?
Can you come in?
No.
All right.
Do I need to do something with this?
No problem. So you can hit okay.
No, I don't want to mess with that. Hit my intro music?
Yep.
Or... Oh, is that time yet? Is it time?
Yeah, you can hit it. You gotta stop that one though.
Oh.
Stop the playlist over there.
And what?
You just gotta hit stop. Right there, yeah.
Okay. Is this what I do with this? Just leave it?
No, you leave that.
Okay. Now hit. Alright, today's a good day to do this when I don't have a guest. Oh, you know, I'm like, what am I looking for? Damn headset.
You can just continue the music, whatever you want. You know, talk music.
Alright, cool. I just play some music.
All right, we'll use this one.
The wheels keep turning. Hey, it's 10 o'clock. This is the other edition of Love Baz Love Talk on 103.5 FM WNHH. And we are back in pocket. It is Black Music Month, June. I don't have a guest today. Well, I do have guests. I have Harry. And Sam the intern, Harry the producer, and Sam the intern, who makes fun of his Latina mother and Jewish father.
It's an interpretation. I wouldn't call it making fun. I'd say that I just wouldn't feel right saying the advice and things they say without sounding like that.
I know, but it's funny though. It is very funny.
Thank you.
It is very funny. And I don't feel like you're making fun of them. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you're not making fun of them. What you're doing is you're sharing a bit of what they're like. Yeah. And it is hilarious.
For your mother's benefit, you are making fun of
them. Oh my God.
Well, yeah, he is.
She would not get mad. Yeah, if anything, my dad would get mad. Whenever I do his voice, I sound like Woody Allen. If anything, he'd be the one that gets salty.
Oh, God. And he's an only child, which is hilarious. So that means he's smothered on both sides, right?
Yeah.
Mother and father.
That's my mom. That's my mom goes by. She, like, if I don't come home at a certain hour, she'll, like, start sending me sleep statistics. Mira, this is what happens on your brain when you don't sleep somewhere. You must. Like, oh, my God. If I could pull out the receipts right now, I don't even want to take up the whole app. Like, last night, she texted me 11 times because I wasn't home. And it was, like, 11.
What's your curfew?
I don't have a curfew. I'm almost 20.
Well, no, but she's actually, you do with her.
No, it's not a curfew. It is a rough suggestion. It's not like.
What? Yeah, well, see, I'm a mother of a 20-year-old. See, let me hear this mess. Let me hear this mess.
So, no,
it's a like, rough suggestion?
Yes, because she's gone through 19 years of World War III trying to get me to do this. And
hashtag
that.
Boy, bye. What?
These texts I got last night from my mom, memes. That's what, look, she sent me that last night, the effects of sleep deprivation, and it is a...
See, I hope I live long enough to see you with, this is what I say to my kids, I want to live long enough to see you with your kids.
Oh, I'm going to be worse. I'm going to have them on tracking, I'm going to be...
Well, by that time, you probably will be able to... They'd probably be able to hologram themselves. Look, see, I'm at the party.
Yeah, well, I won't be mad. I'll be the cool
look,
one.
Look, I'm over here.
You think you'll be the cool one?
No, I was kidding. I'm not going to be cool.
No.
Yeah, because
we all think we're the cool ones until our kids show up.
When you have to actually put your foot down, it's your kids realize, my parents ain't cool.
No, they're not cool at all.
I feel like cool parents, like...
They're the worst.
Yeah, because they're like... Your kids are end up cool. Like,
you know, they end up being slouches. Although, I am so not. I am a cool parent. Like, my kids' friends think that I am cool, but that's because they don't live with me.
Right. Right. Because my son's best friend would say, "Mr. Drews, you're just so cool. I don't know why Emmanuel is always mad at you." I'm like, I'm cool because you're not my kid.
That's it.
I don't expect my.
I actually talk to you. I'm not yelling at you. Right. But if he was at my house.
Yeah, my parents are so nice to my friends.
Right?
How do I get this treatment? What do I got to do?
So you should, you know, be mindful of the fact that parents can't rest unless they know their children are home.
No, but my mom lives for it. I don't think she loves it.
She lives for it because she lives for you. You see, that's why you guys don't get it. That's what the kids
do. I get it, but it's kind of like I'm almost 20 years old, and she still sometimes will not go to sleep until I come home.
Boy, what does 20 mean? It don't mean a daggone thing. It just means you're 20.
I live in Orange, Connecticut.
What's she talking about?
What is the most trouble I could get to? Cow tipping? Like, what am I going to do?
Listen, I don't know what the little crazy kids do out there, but I know what you ain't going to do.
Cow tipping. Sounds crazy.
It's all right. So your birthday is in 3 days.
Yes, ma'am.
So what are you going to do?
I'll be working on Monday. I'll be here.
That's right. No birthday holidays here.
Yeah.
That's right.
I should have taken the Jewish holiday. I don't know why I didn't pull that card in the last 2 days.
You got to work all your cards, man.
I don't know. I don't have any big plans.
Does your father live here in Connecticut?
Yeah, he lives in Guilford.
Okay. Oh, he's on the other side of town. On the other side.
Yeah.
Because your mama lives in Orange and he's in Guilford. Okay. Yeah. So now do you have room over there, too?
Yeah. And my dogs are there, too. So
you have dogs?
Yeah. I have a French bulldog.
So that means your father is taking care of your pets.
No. Wait. No, he, of course he is not. He is, I can tell you what he's doing right now.
So the dogs feed themselves.
He's in his bed reading yesterday's newspaper because he hasn't gotten today's newspaper.
Is he listening today? Does he listen?
Yeah, he does listen. Kind of. He listens on Facebook if he can figure it out.
Mr. Handelman. Is it Handelman, right?
Haddleman.
Haddleman. Mr. Haddleman. prayers.
That man, he's awake though. He's awake. He's just sitting in bed though. Probably watching MSNBC or something.
Yeah. So
MSNBC poor
he's
guy.
Taking care of the dogs.
Yeah. Not right now, but like taking care of the dogs for is like sleeping with the dogs. So it's not like.
He's saying, are you there feeding them right now? Are you
no, walking them? No,
You're at work.
Yeah.
But when you're at school, who takes care of the dogs?
Well, it's my dad's dog. Like, it's my dad's.
Uh-huh. See, you see where I'm going with this, Harry? See how they claim the dog, but the dog becomes. See, that's why I don't have pets. My kids all wanted pets, and I was like, no. Because I could see into the future.
Yeah, yeah, anytime we can,
I'm not getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning, walking no daggone dog and cleaning up poop.
Well, no one wakes up at 4 a.m.
Like, dogs got to go out.
Not at 4 a.m. What kind of dog goes out at 4 a.m.?
What time do they go out?
Whenever. The French bulldog, his name's Wallace, and I named him after Biggie, and he goes out. He goes out whenever I wake up. Like, whenever I wake up, that is when he sleeps with me. So he passes out and wakes up whenever I wake up. Whitney, the other dog.
After Whitney Houston?
Yeah. She is a puppy.
Oh, my God.
And she goes out, like, at 7 a.m. That's what you're talking about. That makes sense.
Okay.
But she's a puppy, so.
Yeah, and puppies are like having children.
Yeah.
They require a lot of attention and work.
Yes, ma'am. Trust me.
And how often do you go over your father's house and take care of these dogs?
It hasn't recently. It's been
Have you been over there since you've been home?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I love hanging out with dogs, playing Grand Theft Auto, sitting in my bed. I got surround sound stereo in my room. Like, I'm chilling with the dogs. It's pretty nice.
And when's the last time you took the dog? So when you go over there, do you just take full responsibility as a dog? Or do they have to remind you?
No, I think I'll feed, I water, I like keep them alive, I do everything I need. I'm pretty good with them. They're not bad. All my other pets didn't work out well. My mother is responsible for the death of, I'd say, 6 of my pets.
What kind of pets did you have? Why is she responsible for the deaths of the, weren't they your pets?
Wait. See, before you say that.
This
before,
is where kids so, get it twisted.
After I tell you, you're going to be like, oh, I was wrong. It's her fault. I guarantee it. This time, all right, let's start with the cat. The cat's name was Sylvester, black and white. I don't even like cats. She thought it was good for me. She said it would calm me down, whatever. She watched one too many minutes of the news, and she thought getting a cat would work. She got this cat, right? And it's an indoor cat. And she let it out one day, because she was like, "I need fresh air, mira." And it got bit by something, but it came home 2 days later, and it was dead in the basement.
Oh!
That's one. That's not my fault. All right.
That might be her fault.
Yeah. So I had a guinea pig. Right?
Although I'm still on mom's side.
I know, because you're mom too, so you probably think like, it's got to be, not this time. So I went to football camp when I was in fourth grade. Joe Namath football camp. I did not do that well, but I went there, and I had a guinea pig, and I was like, Mom, can you take care of my guinea pig for 1 week? It was a 1 week camp. So my mom's like, okay, yeah, I'll take care of the guinea pig, it's fine. And I don't think she understood what a guinea pig like was supposed to do. So she set up this little like cage in the back of my house, and she's like, "I just wanted to eat grass. I love this animal. I just wanted to be outside." And I had no idea about this. A hawk came, picked up my guinea pig.
Oh no!
I swear on my life. And I came
and
home.
It was alive. And took it?
Yeah, and I came home, and she was like, "Well, it's gone." And you wonder. The worst part is it happened twice. Two different guinea pigs. She let us die. The other one ran away. Did not get eaten by a hawk.
What's that show? Is it Common Family? You guys are...
What show?
What's that show? Is Sophia...
Oh, Modern Family.
Modern Family. Yeah.
Nah, they love the dog in that show. My mom...
That's you guys.
She killed the guinea pig.
I'm so sorry. Oh my God. See, she didn't kill the guinea pig. The hawk actually killed
it. It happened twice. The next summer, I went to football camp again, and the same thing happened.
It's your fault.
For what? Not putting my animal in a guinea pig daycare?
Where will you take the guinea pig with you?
To football camp.
I don't think you can take a guinea pig to football camp.
Well then if you can't take it with you, you shouldn't have the guinea pig, right? That's the way I saw it. My kids were like, "Get me a dog."
I know, you know what? That's how I feel, Harry.
Get me a dog. I got pugs. I got two pugs, right?
But why would you get a pug?
Two pugs for my kids, because that's what they wanted, right? Oh, we gotta take care of the pugs. The pugs ate through one of my walls. They completely threw one of my walls. In the kitchen. We had them tied in the kitchen. We put whatever they needed.
It's a crazy pet store.
They ate right through the wall.
Oh, my God.
I got rid of the pugs. Crying.
It's like, are you... They're gonna eat our house.
Of course.
Because they ate the house. Either they go or I go.
It was like, well, if I gotta come home to walk these things, to feed these things, and they get upset because you guys ain't paying attention to them and they eat through the wall, because that's what the vet said. Oh, they weren't getting enough attention. Well, I'm not supposed to be the one giving them attention, right? So it's the kids' fault always.
My dog got taken away. I was like 13. While I was at a basketball game for my birthday, my mom gave my dog away. And I came home, I was like, oh, where's Lucy? And she was like, well, you weren't walking her enough.
There you go. See?
That's what I mean. I am not a fan of, I have four kids. A pet was not going to have it. But when my husband and I were newly married, I think a year, two or three years into the marriage, you know, year two of the marriage, we got a boxer because my husband wanted a boxer. He researched, you know, my husband is very anal retentive. Like, he'd research whatever he wanted something, he'd go and do all this ridiculous amounts of research. And so he researched, you know, the best possible dog. So we ended up getting a boxer. And at that time, we were both very, very busy. And, you know, dogs require attention.
Yeah. They're like babies.
They are. And so I'd go to work, and he'd go to work, and a dog be in the house by itself. We came one day, the dog had ransacked the house.
Yeah.
I said to him, either the dog goes or I go.
You know, and the pugs were the second attempt at dogs in my house, right? Because we had a German Shepherd. And I would come home and find droppings on the floor. I was like, wait a minute, what? I must be in the twilight zone, because I know I had the conversation, you guys got to take care of your pet. Got rid of that one.
Oh, my God.
If I have to do the work, forget about it. Forget about it. And I didn't want to be...
Why didn't you become attached? Why didn't you, like...
I don't get attached to anything. Oh. The only thing I'm attached to is my wife.
Ooh.
And my kids and my grandchildren.
And the fidget spinner. The fidget spinner
is...
You got mad love for that fidget spinner.
It's a necessity. Mm-hmm. So this way I could not focus on the annoying intern.
I'm just playing with my magnets. I'm not even hurting anyone. I'm just sitting here.
Lord have mercy.
I ain't hurting nobody.
So is anybody going to see Wonder Woman today?
No, not today. I can't get tickets.
There is no reason to see a movie when it's like insanely packed. It's not a concert. Yeah. It's not like, like, why?
I'm going to go see it, but I'm not going to see it today or tomorrow.
To hear trap music.
What do you mean?
We got some music, man?
We do. Let's go to... I don't have no trap music today, Sam. I'm sorry. And you know what, Sam? I'm going to commit one morning to some trap music.
Thank
so you. You speak to Harry, load up some trap music, and we'll play it one day.
Me and Jeezy really appreciate it. Thank you.
Oh, my God. I'm not going to be a fan.
Yes, you are.
I'm not going to be.
Because it derives from the music you like. That's what you and my dad don't get. We'll see.
I'm not going to be a fan.
So everyone says.
I might bounce to something. I don't know.
Well, that's what I say, you know, some of the music, the actual beats and stuff,
to
get you moving, but that's about it.
Whatever.
But these guys are genius, right? So.
I'm not taking the bait.
Well, you know what? You dig what you dig. You dig what you dig. Just know that I'm not feeling it.
Next week, Sam will be arguing with all the comments we made.
I know.
By himself. Most of you.
Now, I'm going to bring this into drive-by headlines. I'm going to bring all this.
You can't bring it. This is not a headline.
We'll see.
You got to pick a headline. And next week, I have Joe Ugly on my show.
Oh, really? Is that happening?
Yeah.
I got to get tickets printed.
Can I be on that?
I don't know if you're going to have...
I gotta find me a girl in a bikini to hold up the sign, the round one, round two sign.
But Joe doesn't like to be interrupted. So we're going to let Joe ramble a lot.
Can I be a ref?
You can be a ref. You can sit in here. You can sit in here and comment, but you know.
I think I need to have the amulets downstairs. I'm about to sell wolf tickets. We sell some tickets.
Cause all
this
Joe,
is a fundraiser.
All Joe does is ramble, and then he says, you don't let him finish.
Joe Ugly, are you listening? I don't know if
he's
listens.
Coming. He's coming.
I know he's coming. He'll be here.
This is like the WWE. Next week, I'm going to take Joe Ugly down, and I'm going to get him on the top rope.
Well, I'm changing. I'm going to change the title of the show for that. For Wednesday, it's not going to be drive-by. It's going to be The Ugly and The Truth.
Oh, my God.
And we're going to go from there.
Mm. All right. I'm going to play some music because y'all got me worked up here. But that's all right. I'm going to play
12 noon Wednesday, next Wednesday. Joe Ugly and Harry.
I'm going to be tuned in, buddy. I'm getting my popcorn.
I'll be there.
I'm going to play Michael Jackson. Got to be there. That's what. Wait, where is it? Oh,
Indiana's finest, Michael Jackson.
Where is it, Harry?
Who you got? Who you got? In the NBA Finals.
In the NBA Finals, I got to beat them. Cleveland and 7. I bet money.
I don't hear my song, Harry.
Got my laptop.
I'm on laptop.
Oh, it's not playing, Babs.
Why is it?
Oh, wait, am I over here? On that one.
What one?
That probably some technical difficulties.
Yes, yeah. A little bit of technical difficulties. So, talk. Well, do you sing?
No, I do not sing. Michael Jackson sings well.
Is that it? I still hear it. Do you hear it?
One of the very few talents from Indiana. Not few, but one of them. The most notable. Being from Gary, Indiana.
Yes. Jacksons.
Not one of the economically most sound cities in the end, but.
What do you want me to do?
Which track are you trying to get?
Huh?
What track are you trying to play?
I'm trying to play. Got to be there.
Yeah, click on that. Click it again.
Gary, Indiana. I read the story once that Michael Jackson actually went into the KFC of Indiana and. Shut it down.
On to the next one.
Because he bought all the Kentucky Fried Chicken and started throwing it outside of his limousine at people who were around him.
Are you making that up?
No, I swear on my life. That's a real story. And that is totally something.
I think you're making that up.
Look it up.
What?
That Michael Jackson went to Gary, Indiana one time, bought out all the chicken at KFC and started throwing at people.
What?
I swear on my life. I've
never heard that.
I'll show you the YouTube video.
Play anything better, so I'll see if it works.
Alright. Y'all gonna get it on next Wednesday. So we're gonna go with Let's Get It On.
That's cool.
You said what?
Harry and Joe Ugly next Wednesday. Let's get it on.
if Joe shows up, let's see.
Oh, he's calling him out.
Oh, let's get it on. Come on, baby.
Woo! Let's get it. You said Michael Jackson was throwing chicken?
I swear my life. I'll show you the video.
That sounds being racist.
What?
Michael Jackson throwing chicken.
First off, at that time, Michael Jackson was white, so I'm not really doing
it. Hey, everybody.
What's happening?
Let's call it Joe out.
Whoa, you must have heard us. You over here early? Oh, shoot. You done conjured him up.
What was that?
Just calling Joe out.
Oh, you just called me out on the radio?
Oh, my God. Because y'all getting it on Wednesday, so I had to play Let's Get It On.
Oh, okay. We'll see.
Oh, shit.
See if you show up.
Oh, he said the same thing.
I work here.
I can't wait. Let me get my ticket. Let me get my PayPal ready so I can make some money.
12 o'clock on Wednesday. And that's the morning I got the mayor on my show.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah, next Wednesday.
You got to bring a ring card, girl.
Yeah.
Ding, 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 ding. If I was a little thinner, I'd do it. Oh,
what's going on, Love Babs?
Yeah, we're doing our show. Yeah, we just on Facebook Live. Harry, why do I have this red thing on the Facebook thing?
Why are you in red? It's just a mouse.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's just a mouse.
You wanna sit in?
No.
Oh, Babs? I just called you out. You might as well sit in here and take my invitation.
No, you don't want none of this.
It's like the weigh-in when they have like boxing. No.
I know the weigh-in in this corner.
Hold on.
I'll sit.
Oh, you got a chair? No. Let me sit.
This is trash talking.
You're gonna have to slide over.
So you can get in the picture.
Yeah. Okay. I want to get Joe on camera.
Yeah. Oh, this is gonna be good.
Oh, it's gonna be good.
Let's do this. How much clock we have? I'm here early, huh?
Oh, you are. We got a lot of clock. Early?
Yeah. No, actually, I was. I just had to drop off. I had to drop off a check out in Westville. To insurance guys.
So yeah. Turn on 3 also. Labs.
Man, you like my t-shirt over here.
Alright, so we're just playing some music right now, then we're going, I see everybody.
Oh, just as he conjured up the other man himself.
Oh, shoot. Alright, you're going to keep it clean.
Yeah.
You might need Tamiko in here. Need Tamiko in
here. We all just get along.
I'm ready.
I'm with that. And this, June is Black Music Month, so.
What's that?
June is Black Music Month.
I know.
So I'm playing all music. Right. And you know, I love Marvin Gaye, so.
Why not? What's not to love? I mean,
she actually played this for us.
Oh, for us?
Yes! Okay,
let's get it on.
Oh, I gotta pay my parking meter. Oh, I just thought about that.
Go, ooh. You better go. The app.
I got the app.
Are you cold?
No, but no, if it expired, you're done.
I gotta renew it. It's $1. I pay all these dollars and I still get like 8 tickets.
You know, if it's on your phone, you can go.
Alright, so guess who's in the studio hanging out with us right now? Oh, Joe Ugly in the morning!
Keeping it ugly.
Alright, so Harry and Joe. Yeah. Got this beef, well, and they're going to bring it on Wednesday.
Well, here's the deal, you know, I'm God's of the son that I am, the sterilized bastard that is, but, you know.
He's coming right from his 666 area code.
beautiful, nicely said. But anyway, you know, you can't call up greatness without a hearing. I didn't even hear that you guys were calling me. It's
I know, you just showed
spirit up. Pull me over here, you know?
Yeah.
So I decided.
That's how God works.
In the ugliest way, huh?
Pull it down and out.
Is that what it is?
I'll figure it out.
There you go.
I don't distract from this moment.
Oh, no, it's a great moment. By the way, we got to call this the weigh-in show.
It is. It's the way we weigh-in. That's what Sam says. It's the weigh-in show.
There you go.
If anybody feels like coming out and being the ring card, whatever
person,
yeah. Come out. We'll film you. This will be round one because I'm sure it's gonna be.
Oh, it's gonna be
one great of many.
So I'm invited onto your program on next Wednesday, right?
Yep.
Okay. I mean, hey, you know, sometimes
you know that's high noon. Isn't that a Western?
We're gonna have a duel at high noon. You know, so what do you want to talk about, man? Because whatever it is, I'm ready to talk that politics, national politics. Sure. You know?
It's whatever you want to talk about. Actually, I've been inviting whoever wants to come on and try to convert me.
You know, I'm never coming on this show.
No. You see, I'm not here to convert you. You see, that's the whole thing. You know, I save souls, not mine. So work with me.
Well,
I will save your soul.
I know about souls. Are you talking about your 666?
Yeah, no.
You know, Joe had a 666 license plate.
I sure did.
You know,
I sure did.
So if y'all are just tuned in and you're hearing all this witty repartee,
yeah.
You've tuned in to 103.5 FM, WNHH. I love Babs, love talk.
All about the love.
This is my show. But this is the weigh-in show for the pre-show for the fight for the high noon showdown between Harry and Joe Ugly. Because Harry is the resident conservative,
yes.
And Joe is the other son of God.
There you go.
Son. Joe is the town crier.
Oh!
6:09 in the morning.
I can't guarantee, you know, I guarantee you, you're going to be the one with needing these tissues when I'm done.
Whoa!
You know?
Oh, my
I
know.
I guarantee, talk about Tom Cry, you're going to take the state title.
Oh!
Joe and I exchange a lot of words, but, you know, it's never enough because, Paul always cuts us off. Right?
I know. Oh, man. It's like, no, I had to hear it twice now.
Whoa.
You know when two people tell you something, you know, especially in this business, it's a poll. And two people already said, but why do Paul always tell you, hold on, let somebody, let them finish. Hey, hold on, let them talk. I said, I don't know. Maybe it's because he likes to, like, he wants to censor me. I don't know. No, but in all actuality, I probably do get, you know, I get carried away. I know.
You know what it is?
I get all passionate about
it. No, but you know what it is? Is that Paul spends 15 minutes announcing you.
Oh, that's
so he gives
is.
You too much time already.
That is
so,
true.
So now I understand where this is stemming
from. I could
from.
Go around the world and back by the time.
This is stemming from a moment of jealousy.
Pretty soon we're just going to have a whole show that's just the titles of Joe Ugly.
Well, let's not put that past now. Come on, that's not a bad idea.
I'm not going to say one word. All right, so in the spirit of this upcoming battle and this being Black Music Month, we're gonna keep the music going because
Let me ask you a question. You play music all the time on your show?
On the morning at 9, but today I'm playing music because I want to hear some music.
But I hear you. Sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do.
So look, here's another song.
Hear me sing?
This is another song dedicated.
I wrote a country song.
This is another song dedicated
hold
to
on,
y'all.
You wanna hear me play?
No, I don't want to
hear you. There you go.
You might want to keep the magnets away from your phone.
Was that? Yeah, I was just like, that's a magnet. I better move that away from my phone. That's what I'm going to try to call someone.
Nah, that's not the
all right, so this is Get Ready.
All on my phone, and I put that magnet up there, yeah.
Yeah, so.
And you leave it on there?
Yeah.
You don't do anything?
Oh, that's
oh, okay.
And so Get Ready.
Is that like a charger or something?
Nah, that's just...
That's a standard. That's cool. That's cool.
Oh, that's right. You both are tech gadget people. Find some common ground there. Reach out and touch somebody's hand.
Because I hear
make this world a better place.
I hear Joe's peoples over there implying a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
And you know, I can't answer.
Implying or stating facts.
I'm going to come over here with my popcorn that Wednesday.
Yeah.
Oh, it'll be live stream, right?
Yeah.
All right. It's going to be live stream. Where I'm at, I'm going to be watching.
We'll be on.
Absolutely.
We'll see, you know, how ugly
it's like the Thriller in Manila.
You know, I told you I was changing the... Because my show's name is Drive By Headlines, right? All right. But I'm changing it to The Ugly and the Truth, so...
Just on that day.
Oh, The Ugly and the Truth.
The Ugly and the Truth. Thank God
truth.
The ugly is truth.
No, you can't defend. No more defending Rachel. I mean, Mad Rachel. I'm trying to get away from the Rachel
with
Mad
cow.
Because
you know who's got
it
really,
offends other people.
You know who's really gonna get at you about that is my Keisha. So I remember when I first started, and then, you know, I came on. You know, I'm doing me. Like Paul, you know, Paul heard the show before, and you know he knows me. You know. So I'm doing me, and you know, I'm talking about some chick, and it's like, I don't know, I said something. She was like, are you calling that chicks? Why just can't be a woman? I don't know. I said, are you serious?
Well, I use chick, so yeah. I don't mind
she,
chick.
She just had a problem with me saying chicks.
So. I don't like hoes and bitches.
And
I don't like that.
And that.
There.
I draw the line at hoes, unless I'm calling you a hoe. But if you're calling me a hoe,
well,
I take issue.
Well, now what you're saying is you can't play any of Sam's music.
Yeah.
They got some clean. I want the Walmart trap music. Is there some Walmart trap music?
Walmart.
You know, the trap music they can buy, you can buy out of Walmart.
Like Juicy J. That's what
I'm
talking about.
And you know what it means when you get a Walmart anything? The whole song sounds like, and I will go. Can you let the people sing?
Like, no, because I don't want to hear.
Joe, he was saying that there ain't no good music here in the neighborhood.
Who said that?
Me? I didn't say anything.
Say
I said I haven't heard any.
Well, there you go.
Oh, you got to go over to Joe Ugly to the independent listeners.
Let me get this man some.
Get him some music.
You know, I'm getting ready to do a festival.
Where?
Right in the back of the
Let the inner city be one of the sponsors. Do me an ad or whatever and let me be one of the media sponsors. We'll run it from now until the festival, whenever you say. Seriously.
It's all local, right? All local artists?
Guess who I might bring in?
Who?
W Fresh.
Oh.
Let me clear my...
Yeah.
If you could get LL Cool J, I might be right there.
I might be able to do that.
Get him up in the nursing home.
LL?
Ooh. You want to see 20? When's your birthday?
Yeah, really.
Three days from now. He ain't going to make them comments.
Monday? So, sir, Caleb, from our station, he's Monday, too.
Yeah.
Well, how old are you?
20.
You're going to be 20?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Joe, you need to have him on your show.
No. He's not ready.
Because he's saying...
You never listen to Ugly Radio?
No, he doesn't. I'm telling you, listen to Ugly Radio. Because he's saying, you know, this trap music is the best music in the morning.
Very misconstrued. I like old rap music.
We don't just do old rap. We got trap as well, but it depends on what it is. It's got to be low. If it's coming off with quality, that's all I look for. Quality is something that, let me say this much.
Can we come back?
We should come back
because I don't play two songs.
Today's music, it has to be able to move. You know, I'll be able to sell it. And where do you sell today's music? Video games, movies.
It's coming
and
back.
And we have artists that's where their music is. So if you're not on that quality, that's what we look for.
I need some artist names, though. Who are you talking about?
Got Northern League. We have the whole Olympus Music Catalog.
Hey, Markeisha.
Hey, Markeisha!
We got Manny James.
Markeisha called me out yesterday.
She did? Why? What'd you do?
I would love to hear. I just don't know anybody out there.
Global warming?
Just listen to me.
All right. We back up, people.
That's what we do.
We are back up. I let that go a little long because it is Black Music Month. June is Black Music Month. And, you know, I just have a thing for the Supremes.
June is Black History Month.
Yes, June is Black Music Month, not history. Black Music Month.
I think February
same
is
thing, right?
Black History Month, right?
Yeah, February is Black History Month. But for those of us who are black, 365.
I was not waiting for June. That's why I own a radio station that only plays.
I use February to educate my white brethren and sisters about Black History. Yeah. Too. I don't talk to them. I just share with them.
Because I do that 365 too. Oh, you need to hear this. Oh, it's June. You don't want to hear it? I'm sorry. You got to hear this.
Joe makes everybody feel bad on his show.
Oh!
Wait till you and I get together. You're going to need a doctor.
Oh, my God. Lord have mercy. If y'all just tuned in, let me just remind y'all, this is Love Babs Love Talk on 103.5 FM WNHH. Just so you're
confused. Don't confuse Babs, Love Babs, with the ugly in the room.
Don't get it confused.
I don't know why I agreed to this. Because you know I'm all about the peace. I'm all about the love.
No, I'm all about the peace. I'm all about the love, too.
I'm like Diana Ross. Reach out and touch.
Mike Tyson reached out and touched a lot of people.
Like that great philosopher said, can we all just get along?
Oh.
Welcome to LA, where we treat you like a kid. Rodney King.
Oh my God. Ooh, y'all are witty this morning. Look at all this wit. How much coffee has been ingested?
Yeah, I guess so.
Ooh, we should do talk after dark. Late night talk. Let me just get loose.
We could do that.
So next week, one day next week, we're going to devote some. We're going to devote one of the shows to trap music, since I'm such a hater.
You're gonna let me on. You're gonna let me put you on.
Yeah.
Are you really a hater of trap music? Yeah, or you just
No, it's a
miscommunication.
No, I'm just curious. Why?
Because the concept trap music came out of the game. Right, the drug game.
So a lot of rap, a lot of 90s rap.
And
dude,
I don't like any of that either.
You think Nasty Nas was out here not being surrounded by the same thing? Nas,
Jay-Z, a whole bunch of these guys.
But that was
Jay-Z stabbed someone.
Even still, but that's a different kind of.
That's a different. Yeah.
It is a different kind of.
Snitching over here, Jay-Z stabbed.
He got off, right? I'm not snitching.
Let's just say, if someone who's listening who knows someone who knows someone who knows someone, exactly. Who knows someone who knows Jay-Z, just tell them Joel, we gotta stop. Joel, fall back.
That's all right. I'm not worried about it. Listen, I'm not gonna listen. Everybody ain't gonna dig everything. I'm not against people digging trap music. Me personally, I don't dig it. I know.
All right. That's fair. I think that if I just show you the lineage of how
She just don't dig it, and I understand that. I respect that. Really, you know. I recently went through that with my sister. We're from Trinidad, and you know the music that's popular in Trinidad is soca, calypso.
Yeah.
And I have no connection.
And you don't really dig it, right?
You know, I deal with it.
Calypso music is like the bomb.
What's that?
Calypso music.
Oh yeah, well a lot of people feel that way, but me, I'm a huge reggae fan.
Yeah. Well.
I am more reggae than I am anything, really. I own a hip-hop radio station, but I'm more reggae, which, by the way, hip-hop came from reggae. It came from Kool Herc, who's Jamaican, who started with the Blembeats.
That's what I was saying. I think if she sees the lineage more, how you get from Curtis Mayfield to Kanye West all the way down to Young Thug.
I get it. I do.
Like,
no, I get it, baby.
It's a straight line.
Why am I playing with these? Who's this?
It's his. I was playing with it.
Is that the thing? The little.
No.
I left my little.
All y'all attention deficit little. People.
Oh, I'll be honest, man. I got ADDDDDDHED and plus.
Let me just remind people. This is my house. This is Love Babs, Love Talk.
Whose house?
Babs' house. 103.5 FM WNHH. We are live streaming on New Haven Independent. You can catch us on Facebook. You can see all the characters right there and on YouTube.
By the way, I'm loving my beard in this camera.
I know it is. You're looking hot.
You need a little spread.
You need a photo shoot.
You cleaned up today. What? You're coming from court?
You know it. What do you say to the brother in the suit? Would the defendant please rise? Huh?
Oh, you know what? Oh, time for some music. See, y'all done got it. Let me remind y'all. Let LaRosse remind y'all.
You see, the key to counteracting any criticism is to throw it out first. You throw it out there first, you win. You know, it's like, I mean, you can't never come at me now like that anymore. That's the end of that. You know, I just, you know, it's like,
you know what?
It's like Joe ugly. I mean, somebody called me ugly, and it's just stupid. You know, it's like I already threw it out there first. You know,
I know. I won. Somebody asked me, he's like, why does he call himself ugly? He's not ugly. I said, sometimes the truth is ugly.
That's what my mother said. She's like. Because when I first started here, that we started doing the ad,
yeah.
The Ugly and the Truth,
yeah.
She's like, but why do you guys call him ugly? I said, we don't call him ugly. he calls himself ugly. Oh, he's not that ugly.
Okay. Well, I think one of the greatest things is to hear people argue with me. I'm not ugly. Oh, that's a beautiful thing.
You got a lot of tickets, he said, on your car.
I have a lot of tickets on my car.
Yeah.
You know what my car, front?
Yeah. They say, why?
Yeah.
Oh,
he's you want me. Y diciendo que un ticket que ella tiene ahí que no. Algo que ella puso para que no le pusieran ti. Dice que es illegal.
Damn it.
You parked in.
I'm parked out front. No, I'm not parked in the handicap.
In the reserve spot?
No, I'm parked in the regular. No.
Are you parked in the front?
Yeah.
Oh, the front is a reserved spot.
Where? Right there? Yeah. What do you mean reserved?
Is it a bag on it?
No.
Time to go check it. Because you might be confused.
Can we go check it?
Car. Yeah. You know where I am. I'm right in front of the
Hatters. Yeah, check my car. I'm about to get ticket number 8 of the week.
Jeez. I'm about to contest that mess. Because I should be fine.
Did you heard my show this morning. I was like on again, jumping ugly with Meter Maze first thing in the morning.
Oh, first thing in the morning.
You know what my car looks like, right? It's like right in front of the Hatters.
It's like Tony really got them working out though.
And I have my meter thing on.
You know my attitude is like
I'm so tired of this mess, man.
With the parking meter?
Yeah. Like, you know what, Tony Harp, you need to make a summer of no parking. No fees. Like, just make it free for the summer.
What I would like them to do, however, is to go back to the 5 o'clock cutoff for parking downtown.
Yeah, that would be that.
I know, that 9 o'clock-ish gets on my nerves.
I mean, I know they make, I think that was Kilpatrick's idea.
That 9 o'clock is a drag. If you're in a bar and you hanging out and you got to deal with that mess.
They make money on that thing.
And then they were like, well, you can't stay in your parking spot. You
got to move around.
What is that? You know what? Then I don't even want to be downtown.
No. You do.
And I don't want to go in the lot, in the garage.
But the thing about it is, if you own like a...
See how pissed off I am?
I know. But the thing about it is...
You got to wrap it up?
Right. Downtown don't even have any more stores per se. They're more restaurants than any damn thing
else.
You
know, you're right.
So it's like, and then with stores, that makes sense because they want people to rotate and go to the stores. Not to every store, there's 9 restaurants.
All right, so the next time the mayor has a talk in, I'm gonna have to call in and complain about these daggone, this parking situation.
It's gonna be my show. Oh, yeah.
You know what? Monday morning, I'm calling in.
Yeah, Mayor Monday.
You could call her. I just go there. It's like, listen, Sister Mayor. She's
here Mayor Monday. So.
I know. So I'm going to have to, like, Sister Mayor, listen. We have to do something. Summer is coming. I feel like I personally have rescued this city's tax issue based on personally with my part paying my parking.
Could she, like, pardon our tickets?
I need something, to pardon my tickets. I feel like my tickets are equal to my mortgage.
Oh, man. I think everybody gets a four.
I'm funding all these schools based on my parking tickets. I'm tired of this now.
I got one this week, and I'm right there. But I had to go somewhere, so I parked out on the street. So next thing I turn around.
You got a ticket.
I got a ticket.
And where are these people? I think these meters.
I think they fall out of the sky.
I think these meters buzz them. Like, there's some component that they have that we don't have that lets them know, oh, that meter over there on Elm Street is about to
run fast, run
and go ticket that.
Yeah, you see the manholes lift and they come
They come out the manholes.
Like these ninjas. Now we start turning over though. Start turning over these trash cans, making sure they ain't under there. flipping some cans and what have you. I don't see, I was like, where are they? And you never see them. I never see them. But they hit you like a ninja. So I had to get up out of here. We have pundits next. And that's more talking on 103.5 FM WMHH. But for the meantime, in between time, you've been hanging out with me, Babs Ross Ivy, on the Babs Love Talk. Okay. And it's been fun. We've been playing music for 2 hours and talking and hanging out. This is like my own personal clubhouse.
And that's cool, isn't it?
I love it. I've been having a good time.
By the way, tell the listeners that love Babs, since you like music, stay connected because, we're going to have a music fest coming shortly downtown here. I got that for you guys.
I'm looking forward to it. I like music outside.
Yeah, this is going to be real cool. Man.
I love music outside. All right, Harry, now I got to find. Got to find my intro, outro music. It's a lot of work. Radio ain't easy, baby. Let me tell you something.
No, it is. But the cool thing is for us to always make sure that we make it look easy.
I don't think that's... I make it look anything other than like I'm crazy.
No, that is.
Believe it or not, I'm a relatively smart, intelligent woman with a myriad of degrees. But somehow or other, just this hand-eye coordination.
Just pick any song for your outro.
You know what? I was like, listen, you're going to go with Diana Ross. All right, I'll see y'all later.
Yo, this is so addictive, man.
Paul's gonna wanna go quick since Joe is here right now.
Oh, I know it. You get out the way.
Since you're early today, Joe, Paul's gonna wanna go.
Oh, Lord.
That's what he was saying. Lost in translation. I wonder if that's what he was calling me about.
Who is this?
La Voz over there.
and my phone was buzzing.
Oh, because of the ticket thing?
Yeah.
That's crazy. What did you get these from, man?
Magnet?
Huh?
Magnet?
Yeah.
From some Chinese website.
Is that right?
Yeah.
These are cool as hell, man. My hands swell up so big, man. It's like my ring don't even fit on it.
What's the recovery time?
Supposed to be right now. It's me. This thing was supposed to be down, but I'm not sleeping. So,
you taking pain meds?
It's not painful.
Huh?
It's not painful. It's just that.
No, I know, but the pain meds, they keep you in a dream state, but yeah, you don't sleep.
You know, I did, what's it called? The first day. Yeah. And I'm walking around the house doing this.
You like Tiger Woods.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, I'm doing the Tiger Woods, you know. My son took his phone up, and you know, I'm very conscious of it. Every time I see somebody doing this with a phone, I'm very conscious of it.